Hello guys, welcome to C Learning with new video. In this video we will learn about dealing AP. We will have a review on dealing AP. Dealing AP 2610, it's the model of dealing AP. So its default IP is 192.168.0.50. So I have already mentioned here that its default IP is this is the default IP. So first of all, when you restart reset this AP, so its default password is admin. So I am opening notepad. Admin is default password. After that you can reset your password. So I have set my own password. So I will log in. So normally this of the dealing APs and this model of dealing AP is normally work as a standalone and independent mode as a paired AP. So its model is here, firmware is here, and then we set, and here you have a wireless connectivity. So here you set your wireless SSID. So I am setting this SSID as D-Link test AP. So I enable visibility, enable chat channel is enable, auto channel enable, and bandwidth you can select the bandwidth. Authentication is open. If you want to select the key, so you have to select the key, make it open. So if I save, disable encryption, disable, and then if I save, so wireless AP will broadcast. So it do not have more options like in advanced Huawei APs. The Huawei APs work in fit mode and pet mode and cloud mode, but these APs do not have that type of options. Mostly they are work independently in a fit mode. They have a controller, but their controller is not in hardware form, so they have the software type of controller, so you can install that controller and manage. So they have a drawback that their controllers cannot manage the different types of APs. Means different model of APs are not managed by a single controller. So this is the drawback. So let's go to other reviews. So basic setting, and basic have wireless setting, and then we have a LAN setting. So you can enable the static IP or the dynamic IP by DHCP. To this, so you have to select the gateway DNS and save, and then your communication will be start. So if you have a port, end port, so here is the IPv6. So here is the IPv6. So if you go in advanced, so you have a performance tab. So here you can select the performance, wireless resources, and wireless sources you can select the limit. So you have a multi SSID, you have an option of multiple SSIDs. So if you enable this option, so you can broadcast the multiple SSIDs. So also you can enable the priority, so you can give the priority to different SSIDs, that this SSID has more priority than this SSID. So you can select the priority as well. So here you can define your VLANs, port list, and the port VLANs, VVIDs, and then you have the intrusion, IPS setting. So if you want to integrate it with the RADIUS server, so you can integrate it by username password of RADIUS. So here is the arc spoofing bandwidth limitization. If you want to limit is the bandwidth, so you can limit the bandwidth. So here is some other options, authentication. So now you can see a primary SSID authentication type is disabled. So if you want to authenticate your user from the remote server, like a remote RADIUS server or LDAP server, so you can enable this setting here. So there is a MAC bypass. Here you can add the restrictions. So here is the DHCP server. If you want to make the DHCP pool here, so you can enable and make your DHCP pool here and save it. So your DHCP IPs to your SSID will be go from here. Okay, and then in basic advanced settings, some filters, you can add filters, wireless MAC address, ACL, WLAN partitions, multiple SSID. You can select the mode, IP filters, so you can filter the source IP. So this IP cannot access this destination, so you can filter this IP here. So here are some uplink controls. So if you want to limit the uplink, so quality of service, QoS, and also you have the traffic manager. So here is a status. So here you find the device information, the complete device information, your wireless settings, and client information. If you have connect any clients, so you will see the client here. So also you have the WDS setting. So here WDS channel analyzer. Here is the statics, Ethernet stats, and packet counts, transmit packets, bytes, and WLAN statistics. So how many packets are dropped, how many packets are retried to count. Here is the transmitted byte, received bytes. So these are the, here you find some logs. So here you find the logs of who accesses the device and which source IP access the destination. So here is a log setting. You can, if you want to send your log to the particular logs, if you want to send your log to the particular log server, so you can type the IP here and send your log to the particular syslog and any other server. So these are the basic settings. So here is a configuration. If you want to save configuration, here is a system. In system, you find the restart, restore. And in maintenance tab, you have a administrator setting. So if you limit the role of administrator, so you can limit here login settings. So retype the password console setting if you want to enable SSH or telnet on console. SNMP setting, if you want to send your traffic monitor, you want to monitor your traffic on SNMP server, so you can write the IP of SNMP server here and send monitor through SNMP. There is a ping control enable, LED setting, and here are DTP control and some other controls as well. In maintenance, you find the firmware and SSL certificates and also configuration file. So if you want to download the configuration file or upload the configuration file, so you can download it from here. So here is a date and time, so you can connect, enable the NTP server and give the NTP server IP. So your time will sync with the, your NTP server, and if you want to manually add manually, so you can add manually. So these are some basic settings. So mostly this API work independently. So so you can set your SSID and you can manage SSID, and you can add multiple SSIDs as well.